Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome to Spec Sense. In this episode, we'll take a closer look at smoke and carbon monoxide detectors. A house fire is one of the most frightening situations for any homeowner. The flames are dangerous, and the smoke produced is suffocating. Even a small fire can quickly fill a room with smoke, making it difficult to breathe and putting your life at risk. Not all fires create visible smoke. A fire that can only absorb small amounts of oxygen will release carbon monoxide instead of flames and smoke. Carbon monoxide is a sightless, odorless, and tasteless toxic gas. The symptoms of poisoning are similar to the flu and include dizziness, headaches, nausea, and shortness of breath. Carbon monoxide can also leak from gas furnaces, gas stoves, hot water tanks, and vehicles. Persistent exposure to low levels of carbon monoxide can cause long-term health problems, while exposure to high levels can be lethal. Since carbon monoxide detectors can't detect smoke and vice versa, you will need both types of detectors in your home. Fortunately, there are combination detectors available. For the best protection, these detectors should be installed in the ceiling on every level and in every bedroom. Well, there are two main types of smoke detectors available. Photoelectric detectors work by using a light sensing chamber. As smoke enters the chamber, it disrupts the path of a laser and triggers the alarm. These detectors are better at sensing slow burning or smoldering fires, like from a discarded cigarette. Ionization detectors use two electrically charged plates to ionize the air in the sensor. When smoke enters the detector, it disrupts the flow of the ions and triggers the alarm. Ionization detectors are stronger at detecting fast flaming fires, such as a kitchen or grease fire. However, due to their design, they can be triggered by dust or steam. A dual sensor detector includes both a photoelectric and ionization detector, offering the best smoke and fire protection. Simple carbon monoxide detectors will be tripped if any carbon monoxide is detected. Advanced models use a digital screen to display the level in parts per million or PPM. It's best to investigate any level of detection, especially if it's over 9 ppm. Any reading above 10 ppm can have long-term health effects and should be taken seriously. If carbon monoxide is detected, immediately vent the area, turn off the source if possible, exit your home, and call a technician. All smoke alarms and carbon monoxide detectors lose their accuracy in detection after 10 years and will need to be replaced. The battery in a battery powered detector should be changed every year. Some devices will emit a short chirp to signal it's time to change the batteries. Non-removable battery detectors have a long-lasting built-in battery designed to last the full 10 years with the life of your detector. Plug-in style detectors attach directly to an electrical outlet and usually contain a backup battery. Hardwired detectors are connected directly into your home's power. These alarms can be chained together and synchronized, so if one sensor is tripped, they will all sound an alarm. Wireless detectors offer the same ability to connect and synchronize multiple devices and are available in both battery and hardwired models. As you can see, smoke and carbon monoxide detectors both play an important role in keeping you safe inside your home. If you like this and you want to see more tutorials and informational videos, then subscribe to our channel. If you need help, you can call or visit an AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.